Hi, I'm Tim Berglund with Confluent. If you had data in Kafka and you wanted to get it into, say, a cloud data warehouse, I bet you could do that. But should you have to work too hard at it? With fully managed connectors in Confluent Cloud, you won't have to. Imagine a newly built interstate highway. What's the first thing you need to drive it? No, it's not a car. It's on-ramps and off-ramps. Otherwise, the highway is of limited use. If Kafka is that data highway, then you need a way to connect existing non-Kafka systems to Kafka so that relevant data from anywhere else in the business is available to your event streaming infrastructure. If it's there, that means other streaming applications elsewhere in the business and in the world have a chance to access it too, which is, in a word, good. And I can't say this often enough. You don't want to write that data integration code yourself if you can possibly help it. You want to build features that serve your customers directly. For integration, you want to plug components into your system like they were Lego blocks. If your infrastructure isn't making this easy for you, you should be asking it some direct and potentially awkward questions about its life choices. Let me show you how Confluent Cloud and our fully managed connectors serve as those on and off ramps to the highway system that is your Kafka cluster. And since the connectors are fully managed, you get to click here and there and fill out a form and get a connector running. No bulldozers, no environmental impact statement, no Terraform scripts. I want to show you this with some popular cloud data services, Snowflake and AWS S3. Now, historical Kafka use cases began in the world of messaging, alongside or instead of maybe like a JMS queue or analysis of primary log data from syslog or Splunk or something like that. However, as workloads move to the cloud, and yes, that is actually a thing, despite it being such an overused phrase, we're starting to see different kinds of data integration happening. To wit, lots of us work for companies whose sales and marketing teams use Salesforce. It's kind of the original cloud-native business application. Your company, and we'll call it Blue Mariposa, is no exception. In fact, Blue Mariposa recently migrated from Oracle Siebel to Salesforce because they like Salesforce's CRM solution better. And yes, I am making these details up, but hey, it's more fun if I do. Now, let's say the marketing ops team wants to build an internal dashboard showing lead conversion based on changes in the lead object in Salesforce. Sounds reasonable, right? One common barrier here is Salesforce's daily API limit. You really can't create this kind of business application by directly calling Salesforce's API, as you might be inclined to try. And hey, don't be mad. They're encouraging you to pursue an architecture with fewer synchronous service calls in it, which you should have wanted anyway. This is where Confluent Cloud connectors come into the picture. Specifically, you can use the Salesforce CDC connector, which is a fully managed, pre-built connector in Confluent Cloud, to capture any changes being made on a Salesforce object into a Kafka topic. Setting up the connector looks pretty standard. Got to tell it what topic to put the events in, give it my Salesforce credentials, then some more Salesforce credentials, and finally tell it what kind of objects we want to listen to. That's lead change event here as the CDC name. Finish up the rest and go. Through a bit of movie magic, that connector is shown already running here, and we have a bunch of data captured to look at. We also have an auto-created Avro schema, which is pretty cool. And speaking of schema, let's talk about Salesforce leads for a minute. And this is bonus content here. They have various states like open not contacted, working contacted, closed converted, closed not converted, and so on. Right now, I only care about open non-contacted leads, so let's use ksqlDB to filter to just those. Let's create a topic called leads stream to represent the topic we're capturing with the source connector. Looks like that's got our data in it, as we'd expect. You should see lots of different status values there that are not just open leads. So let's make another stream called open leads, which is a filter on leads stream to only the open non-contacted status leads. Now, when we look at those records, we see only open non-contacted status values here, just like we asked in the filter. So let's get this data out to Snowflake, where our BI team likes to work their magic. This is a sync connector since it's sending data from Confluent Cloud to somewhere else, that being Snowflake. The source topic has a funky name since it's an auto-generated topic created by ksqlDB, the result of our lead status filter query. Then fill out the rest of the typical config, including Snowflake credentials, database name, and then we launch that thing. Remember that pesky Salesforce API limit I mentioned that was really there for your own good? Well, now you've got all that data in a Confluent Cloud topic for you to do further analysis and build more applications on top of, and it will stay current as the connector captures future changes in real time. No API limits anymore. Another common practice is to offload objects to S3 for further static analysis or just low-cost, long-term storage. Configuring a fully managed S3 sync connector should look pretty familiar at this point. Pick a topic, make a key and secret, provide the AWS key and secret, a bucket name, a time interval, and we'll just leave the rest as defaults. Then launch and win. Over in the S3 console, we see that we have records. Again, I sped things up here. You see that we have folders for two separate hours, so this has been running for a little while, but you've seen every step of the setup. This really is all there is to it. So that's a second data pipeline between two cloud-native players, Salesforce and AWS S3, with what I'll generously call a few clicks, but what is very honestly a lot easier than running all this yourself. In this video, I've randomly picked a couple of popular SaaS applications, that's Snowflake and Salesforce, because honestly, they're quite common. There's a good chance your organization is using them or others like them. As more and more of your data lives in places like this, the fully managed connectors and Confluent Cloud are there to help you. Rather than developing, maintaining, and operating custom integrations, which might feel fun at the time, I get that, but it's pretty much always the wrong thing to do, you can focus on building value-added, differentiated applications. You don't have to grind through building and running data integration systems that distract you from taking care of your customers and adding value to the business. Here's a code for you to try our fully managed connectors on Confluent Cloud today so you can see how they work for yourself.